So this little pill right here, this little ass pill, you can't even see it, changed the future of how my hair looks forever. So today I want to give you guys my full in-depth review and my experience using Finasteride. Fun fact, the past week actually marks my 1 year anniversary using Finasteride. So I thought, what a great opportunity, what a great time to actually give you guys my full review and my experience and let you guys know, is this a good candidate, a good solution for restoring your hair and giving your hair back, or should you run away from it because it will kill your dick? So with that being said, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. Alright, so before we get started, I want to make one thing crystal clear, that I am not a professional, I am not a doctor, I am not your hair growth specialist or your dermatologist. I am just a simple guy on YouTube who experiments with different kinds of hair growth techniques, different solutions, and gives you an honest review of how they work and if you should use them. So with that being said, whatever I'm saying, don't take it as a holy grail or as the next Bible for hair growth. Take it with a grain of salt and do your own research to see if this solution is the right one for you, because at the end of the day, Finasteride is a drug and it does come with some side effects, and we're gonna go over those and see if you know, if you still choose to proceed or if not. So just keep watching, because some of the statistics based on data and research might blow your mind away. So what exactly is Finasteride? Finasteride is a drug that is supposed to slow down your hair loss and restore some of your hair, and the way it does it is through simply blocking the hormone called DHT. DHT is the root of hair loss, and by destroying it, you're eliminating hair loss for the most part. As good as that sounds, and like any drug, as we said, Finasteride does come with some of its scary, scary side effects. So the following side effects are as follows. 1, decrease in sex drive. 2, trouble getting and keeping an erection. 3, decrease in semen. Allergic reactions such as rashes, swelling on the lips, tenderness on your chest, tongue, throat, face, problems ejaculating, poor infertility in your semen, and in rare cases, breast cancer. How amazing is that? Now, those are a little scary, but we'll come back to those later. Let me tell you a little bit of my experience with Finasteride, because what I've had was quite the opposite of the side effects. I've had a great experience with Finasteride within the past year with no side effects. I started using it around like the last week of December, it's the last week of December of 2018, or now it's 2019. Trust me, I think this is the best thing I've done for my hair growth to happen. As I said, I do a lot of hair growth techniques and all that stuff that I share with you guys. We've done Rogaine, we've done laser hair growth therapy, we've done biotin, we've done oiling, hair growth exercises, a lot of different various ways to go ahead and attack hair loss or combat hair loss. But the problem with all of those activities and all of those treatments is that they do one thing, and that right there is simply blood circulation. Blood circulation is good, blood circulation is healthy, blood circulation helps grow hair, but the root of the cause of hair loss, or the root of hair loss, sorry, is DHT, the hormone that actually causes it, right? So you can keep doing these blood circulating activities, you can go ahead and keep using Rogaine and oiling and exercising, but all of those techniques right there, they're only gonna help you grow more hair. But if you don't stop the root of the problem, which is stopping DHT, excessive DHT from producing, your hair is gonna continue to keep falling out. So my reasoning for starting to use Finasteride was simple. One is I wanted to attack the root of the problem, and two is 1 year later, whenever it works, or if it doesn't work, or my dick dies, I wanted to make a video on it to share with you guys, like, yo, check this shit out, or no, please don't use this, I messed up. Team single for the rest of my life. Yeah, so here's what my hair used to look like before I started using Finasteride. The biggest thing that I've, the biggest pro that I got from using Finasteride is the density and the thickness of my hair. Because as you can see in these pictures, my hair, it looks very unhealthy, very weak, and it just doesn't look like a healthy scalp. And I remember we took a trip to LA and we took some of these pictures over here. And my hair, I recently got a haircut before going to LA, and that hair, when your hair is weak, it takes forever to grow. So I was having short hair for like 4 or 5 months, and after taking Finasteride for the next few months, my hair growth sped up in terms of the hair that I already have. That also sped up on how fast and how thick it grew. So by the time it was summer, I had nice, luscious, kind of semi-thick hair, definitely way thicker than what I had before. And pretty much the scalp that I was worried about, like back here on the crown, got covered for the most part with hair, so which was amazing. And Finasteride has been a key factor, and I've used many different blood circulation techniques. The main one that I've stuck with was Rogaine. So I was using Rogaine in correspondence with Finasteride, because that way I was able to, one, attack the main issue, which is DHT, just kill it, and two, I was able to use Rogaine, so that way I was killing what was causing the hair loss and I was circulating my head to grow the hair back. That is the most effective way to use Finasteride. And you don't need to use Rogaine itself, because Rogaine does come with some of its cons, like you have to use it for the rest of your life. Well, you can use Finasteride and give yourself an oil massage maybe like 2 to 3 times a week, or you can use Finasteride and complement with laser hair growth therapy, or you can just use Finasteride and do some natural exercises, whatever suits you best. For me, I didn't want to lose the hair that I got from Rogaine, so I kind of had to continue using Rogaine, which I don't mind as much. It's efficient, it's quick, and in complement with Finasteride, it worked really well. And 1 year later, my scalp reached a whole nother dimension of how it looks, so which I was really, really happy with. And this right here is the best I've ever had in my hair growth journey, thanks to Finasteride. Here's the $1 million question. If you're considering to use Finasteride, should you use Finasteride? Finasteride is, it's not something that you can just get up and be like, yo, I'm gonna start using Finasteride today, and yeah, that's it. Like, it's something that you have to seriously consider, because as the obvious side effects that we've listed earlier, and we wanna make sure that you're safe, you are not getting these side effects. I can't answer a yes or no for you, because this is a very, very controversial topic, and if I said yes, some of you guys might murder me in the comments. But two things that I would recommend before you make a decision. One is to consult your doctor and see if you have any specific medical health conditions that might be a precaution or that might make you more prone to these side effects. And two, hear me out on some of the clinical trials that occurred that might make you change your mind on if you should or should not use Finasteride. So here's what happened. There were 73 clinical trials done on various different men, and the study went on for a year of men using Finasteride. And out of the 73, about 2 to 3% of them reported to have some of these listed side effects. And within the first 2 to 3 months of them continuing to use Finasteride, those side effects went away. So your chances of actually experiencing a side effect from Finasteride is under 2%. And as I said, there are obviously outliers to this. If you have a special health condition, a special medical condition that needs attention, then you should definitely be extra careful, right? But if you're just someone normal like me, who is generally healthy, who doesn't have like many health issues, I wouldn't see necessarily a problem with you using Finasteride. But consult your doctor first, consult a dermatologist who knows you and your body type and exactly who you are and what you need, and they're gonna be the ones to tell you if Finasteride is right for you. I know on the internet people seem to make Finasteride such a big deal, like, oh my god, you're using Finasteride, your dick is gonna be dead in like 2 months. And honestly, from my experience, it's not that bad. It's really not. My biggest goal for this video is to let you guys know that Finasteride is not a bad drug. Finasteride is not something that's gonna kill you forever. It's gonna cause you prostate cancer. That happens to people, a very, very small percentage of people who will actually experience a side effect. So if you are considering it as a potential treatment for hair loss, continue considering it and see if you're the good fit. And if you are, do not hesitate to move forward with it, because that's that one thing that's gonna stop hair loss from the root. So yeah, right now going into 2019, that is our best option for hair growth right now. But hopefully in the next few years, we have something that's a little bit more safer, that people feel a little bit more comfortable with. I can totally understand. I used to be horrified of Finasteride before I, you know, hopped on it, did some research myself and see what all the, you know, all the hype and all the negativity is about. And, you know, after all, I took it, it's not that bad. So all the studies, everything that you, if you guys want to read into like further detail and everything, I'll put it in the description below. So be sure to check out the link and read exactly what happened in the study and exactly how many people experienced the side effects if you are concerned about that. If not, and you think you're a good fit, I would highly recommend it to you. And I think this is that one thing in combination with a blood circulation exercise would be the most effective for getting your hair back. So Finasteride worked amazing for me. I love Finasteride. I will continue to use Finasteride for the years to come until I see something, and then obviously I'll make a video about it. So thank you so much for watching, guys. If you guys did enjoy this video or found it helpful, make sure to go ahead and smash that thumbs up button. And if you haven't already, make sure to subscribe and also hit that notification bell so you don't miss any future videos here on Project Alpha. Other than that, thank you so much, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.